Hi, I'm Michele. Today I'll guide you through attaching the nozzle set to your AFC. While executing this step is very easy, it's also crucial to get right. That's because the nozzle set has the very important job of facilitating fluid flow in the AFC. When installed, the nozzle set will live in this part of the AFC tower. As you can see, it is made of this silicon tubing, and your QEV column will connect at the top. Buffer, sample, and all of your cleaning solutions will pass through the tubing and out of the nozzle tip. In the AFC, there is a valve which can be accessed through the settings menu. This valve serves the crucial function of regulating the flow of fluid. When in the open position, the fluid is allowed to flow freely. When the valve is closed, it exerts pressure on the silicon tubing, pausing the flow. So we need to fit the nozzle set properly to enable the valve to do its job. On a related note, it's worth highlighting another good reason for knowing how to do this. While the nozzle set is really quite durable, it is a consumable item that you will want to replace regularly due to the potential for wear and tear over time. Failing to do this can lead to avoidable issues. For details on this recommendation, please refer to the support website. Now, let's get to it. Note that you don't need your QEV column to do this. Remove the pinch valve cover by grasping it firmly and gently pulling away from the AFC tower. The silicone tubing fits in more easily if the valve is open, so open the settings menu, navigate to the fluid tab, and toggle the valve open. There is one quirk you should know here. The valve is designed to function with a tube in place. In this case, we don't have the tube in yet, so you might find that when you open the valve in the settings menu, the valve does not open. To get around that, you might need to encourage it to open lightly by touching the hammer of the valve. You'll hear it click when it does open. If you look at the side profile of the nozzle set, you can see that one side is longer than the other. It's the long side you want to insert into the nozzle housing, so go ahead and do that. Now, hold the tube at the top and bottom and slide it into place. You need to stretch the tubing downwards slightly to get it into position, just like this. When it comes to checking you've done it correctly, there are two steps. First, a visual check. You might want to pause this video now for a moment and we'll show you a close-up shot of correct placement. Note the alignment of the tubing. Toggle the valve open and closed in the settings menu and look from the side to see that the valve is pinching the tubing shut. And now this is what incorrect fitting looks like. Note that the tubing is not aligned, it has curved around where the valve sits, and therefore the valve will not be able to function properly. Finally, make sure you have total control over the valve. You don't need a column for this. Get some DI water or buffer and add some into the top of the nozzle set. Check that fluid flows through with the valve open and that flow is paused when the valve is closed. Once you're happy everything is looking and functioning as it should, replace the valve cover and you're ready to go. For guidance on using your AFC V2, head to support.izon.com for the most up-to-date user manual, and you can always reach out to support if you need further assistance.